yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We're going to keep it clean. Touch gloves. Let's do it.
No touch. First matchup in UFC history of fighters with an unbeaten streak of 10 or more fights. Kamaru Usman had hand surgery several months ago, was hoping to headline International Fight Week in July. Doctor said he needed more time. Salt Lake City's gain for the UFC 278 headliner here tonight. The challenger, Edwards in red, champion Usman in the black and gold.
Edwards never looked at Kamaru Usman the entire time. Never looked at him. Usman walked across the octagon, got right in his face.
Good early attack by Edwards to that lead leg.
Don't expect these guys to fatigue, as you've seen on so many fighters tonight. Edwards has been here for the past 2 weeks, acclimating to the climate. Usman trains in Colorado at altitude. So both of these guys are prepared for this environment. Edwards slept in an elevation tent his entire training camp. So these guys have taken everything into account. Some good kicks to start by Edwards.
Edwards will switch stances, but he prefers to fight out of that southpaw stance. Big shot by the champion.
He did a great job of getting his hands locked immediately. While the fact that Edwards defended that is a very big moment for him.
No doubt.
Because maybe that deters Usman from taking multiple attacks. You saw it in the Colby Covington fight.
He made a mistake.
Yep, made a mistake. Now the champ's on top. He might not have got there in the way that he wanted to, but he got there.
Look at this, though. Up to his feet again. That's big.
Oh, yeah. Edwards did a really good job of creating a scramble. Just moving to get back up to his feet. Now he's got to attack the hands of Usman.
Well, you see he's prepared for that, the way he framed off with his left shin.
Yep.
The way he got back up to his feet.
He almost swept him. And you know Usman's okay with a fight like this. We saw it in the Masvidal fight. If it takes place in the clinch and he's working in close, he is more than willing to fight this type of fight.
Edwards doing a real nice job early, though, with his defensive wrestling. Usman attacking with knees here up against the fence.
Dos Anjos fight, Woodley fight, spent a lot of time in this clinch.
Great job pummeling under there by Edwards.
Yep.
Getting that underhook.
And we saw this in fight number one. Edwards did a good job.
Oh!
Oh,
look
my goodness.
At this! In the full mount!
And
oh,
that'll count!
Oh, my goodness!
That is a takedown. First time Usman has been grounded in his UFC career.
Edwards did a really good job of getting to the overhook and underhook, stepping over, using his height to crash Kamaru Usman down to the mat.
I think Usman did not expect this. That's one of the reasons why this happened.
Well, Joe, you talked about this on the walk. His offensive wrestling is so much better.
Yeah, it's gotten much better. And he just landed some good shots.
And this is unfamiliar to Usman. He hasn't dealt with this, being on the bottom.
Never before in the UFC, and there was a big elbow landed by Edwards a moment ago.
And Leon is moments away from taking his back. Leon has outstanding back control.
And he's got to the body
triangle. He's got the body triangle. The lone loss in Kamaru Usman's career is by rear naked choke in his second fight. And this is a fresh Leon Edwards on his back here.
Oh my goodness. But he's got, it's on the chin. Usman's got to just keep on fighting. Edwards is going to keep moving side to side to try to get an arm under the chin.
But that body triangle is huge, and Usman must turn his left hip towards the mat to alleviate some of the pressure.
Yeah, Joe, he's got to move it to the opposite side.
Leon's trying to get under that chin. Oh, this is nasty.
It's going to take multiple attempts at trying to switch sides if he's going to get Usman. Usman's doing a really good job of controlling the choke hand.
Perhaps Edwards registered a complaint there about his glove being held.
Usman is almost off the body completely of Edwards. But now Edwards can just start to punch.
Nice little elbow there by Leon. What a start for the underdog challenger.
Huge first round for the challenger. Huge.
It could not have gone any better.
And here we'll see the takedown. Unexpected look. Double underhooks. Here's the trip. Beautiful job by Leon Edwards right into mount and then crosses the legs. Look at this. Takes the back.
It was a nasty transition.
Right away to the body triangle. Phenomenal control by the challenger. Big round.
It could not have gone any better for Edwards in that round.
But this is what we were talking about leading up to this fight. Leon Edwards is a real threat. And a sniper on his feet.
But the power of Usman, if he can land, he can put you out with one shot.
Usman getting away with a little interlock of the fingers in the fence. Now goes to the shoulder strike.
You're dealing with a very confident Leon Edwards now. He knows he belongs here.
Oh.
He just got his foot caught. He got his foot caught in between the cage and the mat.
Usman really putting the pressure on him now. Wow.
Oh, nice uppercut from the champion.
Big shots from Usman. But look at the composure of Leon Edwards.
Usman's really putting the pressure on him now. Losing that round. He hasn't lost a round in a long time. Especially like that. Now his foot got caught. But they have really elevated this edge of the mat. It is not what it used to be.
Good jab there from Usman.
Eye poke. Let's see what happens here.
He goes to grab and, yep, thumb in the eye. Wait.
Well, it kind of went to the side of the eye.
It hit the side of the
corner. It was more like the knuckle of the thumb. You ready to fight?
All right, back underway. Just over 3 minutes here to go in round two.
Leon in his southpaw stance has nasty kicks.
Yeah, he has worked that lead limb of Usman quite effectively early. Nice kick there from the champ.
Leon's very effective, though, in switching back and forth.
He is.
But in the orthodox stance, he prefers front leg attacks.
Coach Dean Thomas, what do you have, sir?
Notice how before Usman strikes, he corrals Leon towards defense before he actually starts opening up. So look for that, because he wants to try to take that space away from Leon's back to keep him from moving.
Oh, good straight left from Leon.
And his corner wanting him to follow it up.
Excellent body shot from both men.
And the one thing, Dean, to your point, Usman never just goes. He always gives a good feint before he attacks.
He stung him with the right hand there.
He did.
Usman got a nice right hand in there.
And gaining confidence with those paws with every passing moment. Oh! Nice left from Edwards now.
Excellent left hook.
And we have seen Usman be here before in these tough fights where he's had to rely on the striking and really elevate himself as the fight went on. And you know Leon Edwards is game for a striking fight.
First takedown attempt of the round comes from Leon.
It's a bad mistake there by Edwards. But I mean, how do you call it a mistake when the last round he ended up on top? and on the back of Usman. I just don't think that Leon's going to shoot a double leg and take down Kamaru Usman.
Usman just controlling here.
Oh, he almost got a knee pick.
Edwards backs himself up to the fence. Nice elbow.
Big elbow by the champion.
Oh, and good one by Leon.
The pressure of Usman is something else, man.
Nasty body shots.
Level change for Usman, and he takes Edwards down.
And he gets it.
That was much easier than Kamaru Usman. His pressure is starting to wear on Leon. And that is all that experience in these high-level moments.
And a nice way to put a capstone on a round in which he got a whole lot done on the feet. Stop. 10 minutes down.
Right here you see Kamaru throw the uppercut. Beautiful, and then body shot, our left hook right around there. He also landed some great body shots in there. Beautiful outside leg kick, low calf. Now you got a straight jab. Left hand by Edwards. Wraps around the guard. He checks the kick, throws another little left hook. And then a beautiful takedown by Usman. That pressure of Usman is starting to wear on Leon Edwards as the fight goes longer.
In all likelihood, 1-1 as we hit this third round of a possible five.
They feel like Usman's bullying Leon now. They want him to be the advancing party. But that's very difficult when the power of Usman's coming back in your direction. And if you've watched Leon Edwards for a long time, Leon fights, it's a clean when he's fighting well. He throws his combinations very tight. He's moving. And he's fighting at his pace. He's going to have to match Usman tonight if he wants to win this title.
Usman softly feints the level change. That inside leg kick has been there all night for Edwards. Good short left from the challenger.
Edwards has got to stop giving ground. He's got to find a way to stop Usman from just walking him down.
Oh, wow. And he gets him again. Easy this time. This is Usman's game.
He reached down for that leg as a fake. Didn't expect it to be there and just took it.
Yep.
Leon up to his feet. But we must remember, this is not normal for Leon.
No.
This is normal for Usman. This is his comfort zone.
Yes.
These grinding wrestling exchanges. Leon may have gotten much better at wrestling, but he's not a Division II national champion.
You don't learn to wrestle like a guy that's wrestled since he's 5 years old.
Right.
It doesn't happen over the course of training camp.
Like, you'll never be a scratch golfer, DC, no matter how hard you try.
No, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter how much I do it. I'll never get to be a scratch golfer.
And it will fade with fatigue.
Yes.
Whereas Usman's technique will not. His ability to keep up in the beginning depends on explosiveness and speed and a lot of other things, and that fades.
But Edwards is doing a really good job of getting back to his feet.
Yes.
But it's when he gets up. It's what he does when he gets back to his feet, the in-between the wrestling exchanges that are going to allow for him to be in this fight, especially if we go to the judges' scorecards.
Perhaps in some part, Edwards managing that gas tank certainly expended a lot of energy trying to finish the fight in round one. Nice connection by him there.
Oh,
now a
nice
knee.
Nice.
That's a good combo there by Edwards.
Oh, nasty shot to the body by the champion.
Oh, and an elbow.
But then that happens, right? Usman comes back, returns, puts him back down. So even if Edwards gets back up, he got taken down and Usman landed shots on him.
Usman mixing the martial arts beautifully here, midway through round three.
He's taking his back.
Just one career win by submission for Usman, came by arm triangle in his UFC debut.
That's a crazy fact, considering Usman has been that dominant, and he doesn't really possess a submission threat. He develops that submission threat, then he would go to the next level. And I don't even know what the next level is when you're that good.
That wasn't inside.
He's trying to flatten Leon out, but Leon's doing a good job of avoiding it.
Leon's got a hand fight. He's got to reach back. He's got to try to get his back towards the side of the octagon and hand fight.
You heard it there from Herb Dean.
Is he warning Usman or is he warning Edwards?
No, Edwards. When Edwards reached back, he kind of grabs the glove a little bit. But the problem is, when he starts to move back into him, Usman just goes to the next step. He, instead of fighting Leon from getting here, Usman lets him go and then goes right back to the legs where he can take him back down.
Kamaru's looking for the neck.
And this is intended to just wear him down. This zaps your energy when you just lay over the top of your opponent.
He might have a guillotine here. Dominant round for the champion.
Yeah, it's a big round for Kamaru Usman. And again, that championship level experience is starting to show itself. I used to love this position, Rogan, where you just take a front headlock and just sit on him. It's crunching you. The air waves, they're not wide open.
Dominant third round for the champ, Kamaru Usman. So Leon Edwards has gone 25 minutes in three of his last five fights coming in. Perhaps the altitude is a factor. Usman trains year-round at altitude, but Edwards visibly fatigued there after 15 minutes.
I love the cornering of Edwards. They're telling him, hey, you got to let your hands go, Leon. They don't like that he's being so passive, because this pressure's not going to slow down from Usman. He's going to continue to do this. It's what he does.
Leon's got to do something to get respect.
Yes.
He's got to sting Kamaru, and he's trying to do that now.
And we've seen Usman hurt. Gilbert Burns had him hurt.
Nice kick to the body by Edwards. They don't want him backing up whatsoever.
Look at this. Look at this. Leon's taking Kamaru Usman's back.
Kamaru overswung there. But you see Usman hunched over. He's fighting the hands. He's hand fighting there, and I can't see the angle. From the front, yep, you see him fighting the hands there of Leon Edwards, trying to break the lock. Usman got away with a fence grab again. He did it again.
He's gotten away with that a lot tonight, boys.
Bro, I mean, it changes the fight.
It changes the fight in a huge way. Visible sign of frustration from Kamaru Usman. He just kind of shrugged. He did it again.
Well, Edwards has got to get his hands behind the elbows of Usman if he wants a chance to finish this takedown. But nope, he let him go. But now he's got to go forward, though. Like you said, Joe, he's got to get respect. Taken down again.
He kind of submitted to that one.
That was far too easy. That was the easiest takedown Usman's got. And he's tired, right? Leon Edwards is tired. I talked about the altitude tent. I talked about getting here early. But I didn't factor in the pressure of Kamaru Usman.
Sure.
Keeping him on his heels the entire time.
And the fact
wrestling.
That Usman has been training at altitude for years. He's adapted to it. It's a different thing.
Yes.
Let us now check in with Dave Lavelle in the corner of Leon Edwards.
Listen, get your legs involved.
Come on, Rock, you gotta get to
You ain't doing much, Leon. He's winning the round. Open the legs, friends. Knees
Leon,
inside.
Get your knees inside. There you go. There you go. Get your knees inside.
2 minutes left, Rocky. 2 minutes left.
The cage is there, Leon.
Leon, use the cage as well. There you go. There you go. Don't let him collect your legs.
Don't give your back.
And that's the difference as the fight goes long. Leon has kind of accepted getting taken down.
Yes.
Opposed to defending with all of himself before the takedown happens.
And with each one of these exchanges, when Kamaru's making him carry his weight, it's draining Leon Edwards' gas tank. He's back up.
He's going to have to break this lock, and he's going to have a big minute and a half if he wants to win this round.
Sometimes the mind will not align with the body, right?
It sometimes does not happen. Edwards got to fight the hands there if he wants a chance. He's got to break away from Usman and let some real offense go.
And Usman just in perpetual motion, under a minute to go, round four. Mixes in a few strikes, changes levels, dumps him down again.
But look at this. Leon almost reversed it, but back up to his feet at least.
Hey, you know what? Back down. Back down. Look, come here. Back down. Right there. Back, same position. Back. Back down. Back.
So Herb Dean saw a fence grab.
Go.
Blatant. And so he puts the fighters back in the position.
That's huge.
Yeah, he used the fence to get up.
And that's why Herb's the best.
Yes. Because that is what should happen.
Yeah, he recognized what caused that stand-up.
You know, Edwards has all the skill and ability to compete with Usman. But right now what's separating him is just Usman's spirit.
Oh.
Beautiful
big
sequence.
Shots from the champ.
Body shot for Usman now.
Oh.
Edwards covers up, and now an uppercut and elbow.
Kamaru's all over him.
Usman letting it all go now.
A dejected challenger.
Yes.
20 minutes down, 5 to go. All right, 5th and final round. We'll see what Edwards has left.
This is do or die for Leon Edwards. What happened? Was that another low kick?
Yeah, but Usman said, nope. The corner of Edwards, I love that. Come on, Rock. You got to go because he calls him Rocky. Yeah. You know, it's tremendous. Sounds like the movie.
But he's got to do something big.
He does.
He's got to do something really big. He's got to open himself up.
Dean Thomas, go ahead, sir.
If it wasn't obvious enough, Leon is broken out. And the biggest tell that you can always know this is because he doesn't give his coach eye contact in the corner. And when they don't give him eye contact, they're ashamed. And he's embarrassed right now of his own performance. This is how you know a fighter is broken. And Leon right now is broken.
All right, he's got 4 minutes to try to wrest away this title.
So, Dean, you think making it to the final bell is going to be his win?
That's going to be a victory for him. That's a moral victory for him. Not getting finished.
Nice post by Edwards.
I mean, they are so sweaty. So hard to finish takedowns. Beautiful takedown defense by Leon. He's done a lot of really good things.
Just not enough to beat the best.
Not enough of them together.
Yeah, it's just not enough to beat the best. I mean, he most certainly is better than the first time they fought, but so is Usman.
Yes.
And Usman is an undisputed world champion now. It's a different world.
And a tremendous response by Usman after a tough first round, had a big second, and has kept that momentum going.
I mean, his cardio, man. Usman's cardio is
incredible.
Like, never gets tired.
And I think that's a big factor is that he's constantly in this altitude. He's constantly training.
And constantly in these fights.
Yes.
Because it don't matter if you're at altitude or in Vegas. If you're fighting Colby Covington,
right. You're
going hard.
Right.
And he has done that twice. And won.
And won. Yes.
And won, yes.
Leon, you're in the gloves. I see you.
Herb Dean doing a nice job, all things considered, navigating a lot of these fouls. Not trying to make himself the story of the fight.
We're halfway into the final round. What is going on here?
He broke him.
Just looking for more action.
Edwards has to take advantage of this chance. He's got to go.
Got to take some risks, I would think.
And for Kamaru, he can coast if he wanted to. He's way ahead.
He will not, though.
He will not.
He's going to keep pressuring.
Well, he's going to try to stop him.
And that is what makes him the best.
Yes.
That. He doesn't rest.
There was a good right hand by Edwards.
But that's what Edwards, like that. He's got to keep going, though.
Let's take a look at that. Oh.
That was not low.
That was not low.
That did not look low.
That was not low.
That did not look low.
Let's see that again.
That was not low. It's on the belt line.
That's on the belt line.
Yeah, that's on the belt line.
Interesting.
All right, back underway, under 2 minutes to go.
And when Edwards goes, he can get to Usman. His kicks are very fast, even in round five. His hands are very fast.
He's just got to open up.
You know, he's a minute and a half from losing this championship fight. So you leave it all out there. It does not matter how this fight ends. When that final bell rings, whether you're laying flat on your back or you're in the middle with your head down, as his hand gets raised, he's going to win. You got to empty the gas tank here.
Yeah.
He may have resigned himself to losing a decision.
Well, that's what Dean Thomas said.
Yeah.
Dean feels like that would be a moral victory for Leon Edwards.
But that is not the cloth from which he is cut. I mean, that is a dejected.
Oh!
No way!
There it is.
No!
Oh, my God.
Undisputed welterweight champ. The belt headed to the UK.
We were writing his obituary.
Oh, my goodness.
Leon Rocky Edwards, your new welterweight champion.
Oh, my goodness. And look at this. He sets it up by showing him the left.
Oh.
And a perfect left high kick.
That is amazing.
I didn't even see it.
Oh, my goodness.
And
Kamaru
Usman, he said to Herb Dean, no way. No way. Yes,
way. Oh, my goodness. Look how he shows him the left to hide it.
Well, he's done this before.
Oh, my goodness.
This is a great combination from Edwards.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
That is what we were saying coming into this fight, that Leon Edwards has such a full set of skills, but we did not think that that was going to happen in the fifth round like that.
Is the reaction back at his gym in Birmingham, England. Leon Edwards has done it.
Leon Edwards just shook the world.
To make it official, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 4 seconds of round number 5, declaring the winner by knockout and new UFC undisputed welterweight champion of the world, Leon Rocky Edwards.
You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.